YOLO Rules Reacts here, and welcome to another blind commentary. Today, I'm going to be reacting to a fanfic reading by Scribbler called Ponytails, The Last Crusade by Para Derpy, which is a sad fiction, or sad fic, as it's called for short. This was requested by Dakota, so, and basically, if it's not already obvious, this is a fanfiction that is meant to be emotionally very sad. And by the fact that it's called The Last Crusade, I'm guessing it has to do with the CMC. So, let's go ahead and get started.
Ponytails. Read by Scribbler.
I have watched some Scribbler stuff before, so I am familiar with her readings. Okay, so it is a CMC. And I guess in this one, Apple Bloom perished somehow.
So glad we made it. Time will never change it. No, no, no.
The Last Crusade by Para Derpy.
Just a little girl, big imagination.
Apple Bloom held her breath as she gazed out of the clubhouse window. The sun was beginning to dip below the tree line as the sky turned a soft, beautiful orange, and night began to creep its fingers across the sky, silently snuffing out the day.
Twilight.
Apple Bloom rushed to the other window, facing Sweet Apple Acres. They told her they'd come from the Apple Family Barn this time, and the time was right. Apple Bloom had already attempted the math in her head several times over to confirm that. She had always been an impatient filly. Well, perhaps not as impatient as Scootaloo. But when something was on her mind, she just couldn't let it go.
Not as impatient.
Nothing would change that. Her heart beat feverishly, and she began to feel as if she were breaking into a cold sweat, although she felt no moisture, just the sensation. She remembered that feeling. It meant anxiety. She'd felt it often enough before, whether it was from her sister Applejack's annoyance with her from some clumsy mistake, or perhaps just a bad feeling before one of Scootaloo's ridiculous cutie mark crusade schemes.
I decided to turn it up slightly.
The filly smiled softly. They'd been through so much together, the three of them. Just the thought of Scootaloo and Sweetie Belle made Apple Bloom's heart skip a beat in joy. Her thoughts turned to her sister, Applejack. Oh, how Apple Bloom wished she could come to the clubhouse tonight too, but the filly knew it couldn't be. Applejack was just too old for this. Too mature for mumbo-jumbo, as she would call it. It saddened Apple Bloom to think about it, but she knew too well how stubborn her sister was.
This is before they got their cutie marks, obviously.
She just couldn't see things the way her friends could. But at least she had them. Being a blank flank, the fear of loneliness had always plagued Apple Bloom. The fear of being shut out, having no pony to talk to. Initially, the growing pain had been a curse, but it was because of that very curse that she had befriended Scootaloo and Sweetie Belle in the first place. And they were incredible friends. The best any pony could ever ask for. Apple Bloom knew for sure, these days more than ever, that they would never, ever leave her. The sound of hoof steps broke Apple Bloom away from her thoughts. She sniffed and quickly wiped her eyes with a hoof. It was still habit, and she certainly wanted to do as much as she could to look strong in front of her friends. They had to see that she was all right. She looked out the clubhouse door again and saw two small figures making their way along the path. Apple Bloom could barely suppress the widest grin she'd made in a long time. The filly quickly saddled herself up against the wall, ready to jump out at any unsuspecting pony to open the clubhouse door. A knock resounded from the door, and it opened slowly.
Apple Bloom, we're back. Are you in there?
Sweetie Belle's voice was as sweet as her name.
Of course she's in there. Where else would she be, huh?
Scootaloo's voice, though rough
like
and blunt,
was
just as sweet
Scootaloo
to Apple Bloom's ears.
Well, I don't know. Maybe she's...
Boo!
Apple Bloom leapt out of her hiding place. all the while scrunching her face up, trying to look as terrifying as possible. Sweetie Belle screamed and shot out of the clubhouse like a bullet. Scootaloo's eyes went wide, but her eyelids soon dropped, unamused.
That's original,
the orange filly deadpanned, a smirk creeping on her face.
Oh, shut it, Scoot. I'm mighty scary. You call that scary? I'm 10 times more scary than you, and I'm not even...
Scootaloo's voice trailed off. She looked to the side and cleared her throat.
Hey, Sweetie Belle, come on, stop being such a scary pony. It's only Apple Bloom.
There was a silence. Then there was the clambering of hooves, and a white filly burst through the door, embracing Apple Bloom with her outstretched forelegs. Apple Bloom threw her strong pony facade out of the window and returned the hug as best she could, dry tears running down her cheeks as she pressed her head into Sweetie's soft mane.
I'd be lying if I didn't say I missed you two like heck,
Apple Bloom sobbed into Sweetie's mane.
I know you guys had that trip to Canterlock, and I really do hope you had fun. And I know y'all can't stay here but 24/7, and sometimes I just don't know what to do. All I got is my thoughts to keep me company. I can't do this, Sweetie.
So
I can't.
I guess Apple Bloom is already dead.
Looked up at her friends to see her own feelings reflected on their faces. Even Scoot's eyes were welling up with tears. She didn't like seeing them like this. Not for her sake.
I'm sorry, guys. I don't want to put this on you.
She sniffed.
Who's Applejack?
Sweetie's voice cracked.
She's great, Apple Bloom. Yeah, almost as cool as Rainbow Dash these days.
Apple Bloom smiled at the mention of Dash. As always, she was still Scootaloo's hero. Apple Bloom hadn't been in Ponyville much in the last couple of months. She really wanted to go back into town, but it was just too close to... the spot. She'd gone as far as Fluttershy's cottage, and it was nice to see the kind yellow Pegasus again. But she really didn't see every pony else anymore, except for those who stopped by the farm every now and then.
Why don't you go back to the farmhouse?
Scootaloo asked.
I mean, at least you could see your family more often.
Apple Bloom shook her head.
No, I can't. I tried a couple of times.
Scribblers,
but I think
Apple
I caused
Bloom
them more trouble than anything
really,
else.
Really good.
I think they can hear me, and I always cause a racket. I don't want to bother them, or worse, scare them. How would they ever be afraid of you, Apple Bloom?
Sweetie Belle frowned.
You're the nicest pony I've ever met. We're not afraid of you. No pony should be.
Well, y'all can see me, can't you?
Of course,
Sweetie said as matter-of-factly. But her face soon darkened at the sight of her friends' faces.
What?
Apple Bloom sighed heavily. Scootaloo looked down, but her face soon hardened with a determined anger.
That's it!
Apple Bloom and Sweetie Belle jumped at the orange filly's sudden outburst.
I can't take this anymore! We're showing you to Applejack! Come on!
Scoot, you're crazy! You know what'll happen! They'll think you've gone bonkers! Please!
No, okay?
I guess they're the only ones who can see
her. I'm not just gonna let you stay here all alone and see you like this all the time! You're really lonely, Apple Bloom! And I can't just sit and watch!
Scootaloo shut her eyes tight as a new stream of tears was beginning to form.
I can't!
Apple Bloom trotted up to her and placed a hoof around her shoulder.
Look, Scoot, I know how you feel. Gosh, I'd feel the same way if I were in your situation. But it just ain't happening that way. And you know that. I know you guys care about me. And in the same way, I worry about y'all too.
I just...
Scootaloo's voice was weak.
I just don't know what to do anymore. I worry about you all the time. And it just makes me feel empty inside.
Well...
Apple Bloom's voice became hard.
I've been doing a lot of thinking, girls. I've had a lot of time to think. Maybe I've taken too long to make up my mind, but I know it's gotta be done.
She swallowed.
What?
Now.
Sweetie Belle's face was a mess of worry and confusion. She didn't know what her friend meant by all of this, and a part of her didn't want to find out. She realized that Scootaloo must have known better. As tears began to blind the orange filly's sight.
The spot? No, Apple Bloom.
I gotta, Scoot. I think everybody's got it at some point. Please, don't worry about me.
Apple Bloom looked out of the clubhouse window. Although the night had settled in, a brilliance of light, more spectacular than anything Apple Bloom had ever witnessed, sparkled in the distance, down in Ponyville.
I guess Apple Bloom wants to move on.
But I'm not afraid of it anymore, Scoot. You see, I've heard her talk to me. She's been talking to me a lot lately. She tells me it'll be okay, and I believe her with all my heart. The princess wouldn't lie.
Scootaloo wiped her eyes and blinked at her friend.
Princess Celestia?
Apple Bloom nodded.
But how?
I really don't know. I was as confused about it as you are. It's hard to explain, but I just know she's down there, waiting for me.
Sweetie Belle, who had been silent throughout Apple Bloom's revelation, looked at the Yellow Earth Pony with wide eyes.
I don't get it. What's going on, Apple Bloom?
Apple Bloom opened her mouth to speak, but as hard as she tried, no words would come out. She looked at her friend sadly, stuttering. Scootaloo managed a soft smile and cut in.
We're going on another crusade, sweetie.
The orange Pegasus gathered her friends into a group hug.
One last crusade.
Yeah, I can see why Dakota told me to keep a box of tissues with me for the story. It is pulling at my heartstrings a little bit.
The three fillies trotted on the country road in silence. So many times they had taken this route. The route from Sweet Apple Acres to Ponyville. So many times they had galloped down the path together, laughing, playing, and acting outright silly. They had gotten into so much trouble then, as the route would often make use of somewhat of an escape from an angry adult, or worse, an angry older sister. Now they were travelling it again. But there was no laughter, no playing, no angry sisters to hide from, only memories. But they were memories that the three would share, together. Apple Bloom trotted between her two friends, her very best friends. Nothing would ever change that. A soft smile blessed her face, and her eyes were closed. She didn't need to see. She could already see everything within herself, all at once, past, present, and future. She had travelled down this road so many times before. Her heart knew the way. Sweetie Belle glanced at her friends.
Also really good.
Even Scoot now had a nostalgic smile on her face. She didn't understand. They were so sad before. So was she. Why were they smiling now? Where were they going? What did Scoot mean by one last crusade? Should she be smiling too? But as hard as the little filly tried, she couldn't. Apple Bloom was her friend, and she just couldn't help but worry about her. Something was going to happen, she was sure of that. Something was already happening. But like before, she was still afraid to find out. Her thoughts turned to the past. Everything had become so strange after hearthswarming. Apple Bloom had stopped coming to school. She had stopped coming out to play. Rarity had said she was homesick and needed rest, but days turned into weeks. Sweetie grew angry
Rarity
as everybody eventually stopped talking about her.
Protect her feelings.
Even Scootaloo grew quiet. They wouldn't tell her where Apple Bloom was. They wouldn't tell her anything. Then, one day after school, Scootaloo came bounding into Carousel Boutique. She had found Apple Bloom. She was hiding in the clubhouse. Sweetie followed, and, sure enough, there she was. They played, they laughed, they made mischief. It was just like before. But Apple Bloom would never want to go into Ponyville, and always stayed around Sweet Apple Acres. When Sweetie asked why, the old Apple family stubbornness in her surfaced, and the Earth Pony would say she just couldn't. Sweetie had eventually stopped asking. The strangest thing of all was that no pony really mentioned Apple Bloom. Applejack talked about her on occasion, but it was very strange whenever she did. She'd always wear a sad smile and have a twinkle in her eye.
So Sweetie the Belle, hasn't fully realized that Applebloom's just a spirit.
But whenever Sweetie would mention her new adventures with her Earth Pony friend, she'd get a weird look from her sister and, on occasion, a stern one. Then, one night, Rarity had a talk with her. She had told her Applebloom was gone and couldn't come back.
Okay.
Sweetie had entered a furious temper tantrum and cried herself to sleep that night. The next day, Sweetie frantically begged Applebloom to come to Carousel Boutique, but she wouldn't. Sweetie remembered how angry she had been at her friend. Even Scootaloo just looked at her sadly and shook her head. But now, they were all going to Ponyville together. Sweetie Belle would have felt happy about it, if not for the lump in her throat and the beating of her heart. What was going on? As the fillies entered the town of Ponyville, Applebloom opened her eyes and looked around. She wanted to take in every detail of the place. The colourful houses, the beautiful flowers, even the well-worn dirt of the street beneath her hooves. She wanted to remember it. She wanted to remember everything. The sparkling light was everywhere. It may have been night time for Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo, but to her, it was as bright as day. Soon they would reach the spot. Applebloom took a deep breath. As the three fillies rounded a corner, Applebloom stopped. She looked ahead, but the fear in her heart that she had expected didn't come. In fact, she felt happy. Really
happy.
This
story is ever going to
the
say
Earth Pony
how
smiled,
Applebloom died.
Her eyes sparkling beautifully. Scootaloo let out a sigh, accompanied by a single wet tear. Sweetie Belle simply looked at her friends, wide-eyed.
What is it, Applebloom? Why are you staring like that? You look like you've seen a ghost. Well, if ghosts were really pretty, I guess.
She followed Applebloom's gaze and pouted in confusion. Ponyville Hospital. Was this the spot?
Oh.
They are pretty, Sweetie Belle.
Scootaloo's gaze went to Applebloom, and then back to the white filly. The orange Pegasus smiled. A thousand thoughts suddenly went through Sweetie Belle's mind as she pieced together the puzzle that had stumped her for so long. At last, she began to understand, but she wasn't sure she liked it at all.
No!
Sweetie Belle sobbed as her eyes grew watery.
Applebloom! Tell me it's gonna be fine! Tell me you're still okay!
Applebloom looked away from her invisible wonder and turned to Sweetie Belle.
I am okay, sweetie. In fact, I'm great.
Applebloom's grand smile softened as she realized the sorrow in her friend's eyes.
Look, what you're thinking about me right now? I'm sorry, sweetie, but it's true. I was sick, sweetie, real sick, and, well...
Applebloom struggled for her voice again.
I know.
Sweetie Belle sighed.
I think I always knew. It's just... I wouldn't believe it. Oh, I still can, Applebloom.
The little white filly threw her arms around her friend, realizing for the first time how empty the space really was. But she knew it wasn't truly empty, and so she grasped tighter.
Sweetie Belle... I don't want to say goodbye either, Applebloom cried. But it's not really goodbye. It's more like a see you later, if you think about it.
I just don't want you to go, Applebloom. I don't know what I'll do without you.
Sweetie Belle cried into Applebloom's transparent mane.
Maybe I can convince Rarity, or Twilight, or the princess. Yeah, she can probably see you, and then she can tell everypony else... And you can stay. It'll be like nothing changed. We can try really, really hard. And
sweetie, I have to do this. And I'm sorry it's gotta be so soon. But, well, one day you will too.
Applebloom wiped her dry tears away, and her eyes hardened.
You just gotta trust me.
And me, little one.
This was not the voice of her friend, Applebloom, or Scootaloo, but a motherly voice, as old as time, that spoke now.
Your friend Applebloom, is wise, and what she tells you is true. It is her time, Sweetie Belle, and you must learn to do what is best for her, and let go.
Sweetie Belle was in shock of the disembodied voice speaking to her, but she wasn't afraid of it. It was a loving, caring voice. Eventually, the little filly managed to gather up her strength and spoke.
I guess Applebloom would do the same for me. I know she would.
All three fillies could hear the voice, and her friends smiled at her.
And if I have to do this for you to be happy, then okay, Applebloom.
I will take care of her, as I take care of you all, little ponies.
The voice continued.
And you will see your friend again, Sweetie Belle. I promise you.
Although Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo could not see the owner of the voice, they knew that she was smiling, for a brilliant essence of warmth encompassed all three fillies, and they couldn't help the powerful urge to smile. The three joined together in a group hug, which seemed to last forever. Their tears had dried, and none of them were crying now, not even Sweetie Belle. They just held their loving embrace. No words were spoken, as they all told each other their feelings. In that instant, they were not three little fillies anymore, but one union, one soul. An eternity passed before the friends finally let go of each other. Sweetie knew what was coming, but she didn't feel sad about it anymore. In fact, for the first time, she felt happy for her friend. Applebloom turned to Sweetie Belle and Scootaloo and looked each of them in the eyes.
See you later, guys. I'll love you.
As Applebloom's eyes once again transformed into those beautiful orbs of light, Sweetie Belle could have sworn she saw the form of Princess Celestia reflected in their glassy surface. And the princess was smiling.
Take it easy, Applebloom. See you later, Applebloom. We love you too.
That's the end. Wow. My heart right now. A montage of images from the show, as well as original fan art too.
That was The Last Crusade. It was written by Paraderpy and read by Scribbler. Okay, thank you very much to everybody who's listened in this time. Bit of a sad fic, although I think it's rather well written.
I agree.
This is also an older fic from the fandom. If I'm correct in remembering it, it's from 2011?
Wow.
Oh, yes, checking it. Oh! Christmas Day, 2011.
Wow.
Something of a bittersweet Christmas gift, I feel. However, a good one. I hope everybody else enjoyed it.
I did enjoy it. You did a very good job, anywhere. Scribbler.
And if anybody has any fic suggestions for the future, one-shots in particular, I'm kind of snowed under with multi-parts. So if anybody has any one-shots they'd like to suggest for me, pop them in the comments or PM me or email me, and I'll get to seeing what they're about. In the meantime, be lovely to each other, and good night, everybody.
And this video is from 2013, in case you were wondering. But yeah, that was really good. Scribble did a really good job. I love the voices. I love the music choice. The music really makes or breaks a fanfic reading, in my opinion. And the music set the mood just perfectly. And also Paraderpy's story was really, really good. It was really emotional. It was really well written as well. All of the characters were portrayed well. And yeah, I'm really glad that I got a chance to react to this. Thank you for suggesting it, Dakota. And yeah, I'll put a link to Scribbler's channel in the description below, and her description has a link to the story, so you can check out Paraderby through her description as well. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed this video, give it a like. Also, be sure to like my Facebook page and follow me on Twitter, as well as support my Patreon. All three links will be in the description below. Shout out to my Patreon. Shout out to my Patreon, AZ1598525. Thank you for supporting my channel. And subscribe for more. And if you are subscribed or a new subscriber right now, be sure to hit that bell icon to get notified when I upload videos. This is Beholder Rolls Reacts, signing off. Talk to you later.